Welcome back, children. Today we will start a new chapter, that is chapter number 5, editing text in MS Word 2010. Okay, so in today's session you will be learning starting Microsoft Word, creating a new document, selecting and editing text, moving and copying text, and saving a document. Okay, so let us begin. Now right now I am using Microsoft Office 2019. Okay, so I am going to show you all this activity in Microsoft Office 2019. Now you can see that just after the start button you can see a search box. In the search box simply you can type the word, W-O-R-D, word. You can see that the Microsoft Word application icon has appeared. Simply click on this application. Okay, now click on the blank document, so you can see that the Microsoft Office Word window has appeared. Okay, now before proceeding forward you need to understand what is Microsoft Word. So we can call Microsoft Word as a word processing software. Why it is called as a word processing software? Because using the Microsoft Word you can create letters, you can create reports, notice, letter writings. Okay, not only that, you can modify your text both while typing and after typing. You can say change the color of the text. Okay, you can decrease or increase the size of the text. You can change the handwriting of the text. You can give the background color. You can insert pictures. You can insert shapes. Okay, so for this purpose we call Microsoft Word as a word processing software. Okay, now let me slightly increase the size of the text here. Now you can see one blinking line. Okay, we call this blinking line as a cursor. And remember, your writing starts or your typing starts from the place where there is a cursor. Okay, so suppose say you can see a blinking line there. So let me type, suppose say Techno, okay, India Group. Now if you want to type from somewhere else, you can take the mouse pointer there and simply double click in the position from where you want to type again. Okay, simply double click the mouse pointer, you can see that the cursor has appeared here. Okay, now you can write down your next text in this way. Okay, so always remember that your typing starts from the place where your cursor is located. Okay, so if you want to start another text here, simply double click on it. Okay, see the cursor has appeared, you can type down the text. So always remember, let me repeat once again, always remember your typing starts from the place or the location where your cursor blink. Okay, now next, suppose say if you want to open a new document. Okay, how to open the new document? At the top you can see a file tab. Click on this file tab. Okay, from the drop down menu you can either click on the new option or click on blank document. You can see the new document has appeared. Okay, now I am going to show you how to select the text using a mouse. Okay, so I have already created a text here. Okay, so I have typed two paragraphs. This is my paragraph number one and this is my paragraph number two. So the easiest way to select the text or a sentence or a paragraph is by using the mouse button. So what you can do is, suppose say if you want to select this text, okay, so click the mouse button in front of the text and simply drag the mouse button, so you can see that word has been selected. Now if you want to select the sentence, so press the mouse button, drag the mouse, so you in this way you can select the sentence as well. Now if you want to select the entire paragraph, press the mouse button, drag the mouse button till where you want to select. Okay, release the mouse button. Now you can see that your paragraph has been selected. Okay, now beside this one there are some more ways that you can select the word, sentence or a paragraph. Okay, so let me show it to you now. A word, so you can also directly double click on the word to select the word. Okay, Now see here, suppose say if you want to select this word, take the mouse pointer above the word, okay, just double click the mouse, double click it, you see that the word has been selected. Suppose say I want to select this word, take the mouse pointer above the word and double click it, see the word has been selected, okay. Now next is a sentence. So if you want to select the sentence, you have to hold down the control key from the keyboard and click anywhere on the sentence. So suppose say I want to select one of the sentence from this paragraph, okay. So press the control key from the keyboard and simply click on any of the text here. Now you can see that sentence has been selected. Suppose say I want to select this sentence. So again, press the control key from the keyboard, okay, and click anywhere in the sentence. See, the sentence has been selected. So this is the another method. Now how to select the paragraph? Suppose if you want to select the paragraph, you can click three times anywhere in the paragraph, okay. So suppose say I want to select this paragraph. So I have already showed you the easiest way is just pressing the mouse button, okay, and simply drag it. Your paragraph has been selected. Now another way of selecting the paragraph is take the mouse pointer anywhere in the paragraph, okay, click the left mouse button three times. How many times? Three times continuously, okay. See here, the paragraph has been selected. Now suppose I want to select this paragraph, so let me take the mouse pointer above the paragraph and let me click the left mouse button continuously for three times. Now see, the paragraph has been selected, okay. Now the next one finally is how to select the entire document. So you can select the entire document by triple clicking in the selection area. Means again, you have to click the mouse button three times, but where you have to click? You have to click on the selection area. So you can see that below this one there is some more text that I have written, okay. Now I just want to select the whole document, so we call this as a selection area. Now if you see that once I take the mouse pointer in the selection area, the pointer turns into the arrow pointing upward. So once the arrow, once you see the arrow pointing upward, click the mouse button three times here continuously, okay. Now you can see that not only these two paragraph, the text that I have typed below has also been selected, okay. So this is how we can select the entire document as well, okay. So you should kindly go through this table and just follow how to select the text, that is word, sentence, paragraph and the entire document using some of this method, okay. Now next I want to show you is about the moving the text and copying the text, okay. Okay, now what is difference between moving the text and copying the text? Now you can see here, moving the text means placing the text from its original location to the new location in the document. We can also call it as a cut and paste, okay. So what happens when we move the text? The text will get removed from its original place and it will get shifted in the new location. Now what is copying the text? You can also call copying the text as copy and paste feature, okay. So copying the text means placing the duplicate copy, okay. You can place the duplicate copy of the text from its new location to the another location, sorry, to its new location from its original location, but without removing from its original location. So let me repeat once again. Copying the text means placing the duplicate copy of the text, okay, from its original location to its new location, but the original text will not get removed from its original location, okay. So let me show it to you as well. Suppose say I have typed few texts here about India. Now what is moving a text? Suppose say I just want to move these two texts, okay, two sentence from this position to a new position. So what you need to do is, I am going to show you two different ways. Now the first way is you can see that under the home tab, okay, just below you can see the cut button here. So click on the cut button. Now you just see here, once I click on the cut button, these two sentences will get removed from its original location. Okay, click on the cut button. See, it has got removed from its original location. Now say I want to place it somewhere here, so simply click the mouse button. Now at the left hand side you can see the paste button here, so click on this paste button. You can see that the text has been shifted from its original location to a new location. Okay, we call this as moving the text. Now suppose say I want to move this text again from this position to a new position. Okay, so select this sentence, move the sentence. Now I am going to show you the second way, second method. Now after selecting the sentence or the text, right click the mouse button. You will see that the pop-up menu will appear. From the pop-up menu, click on the cut option here. So click on the cut option, so it get removed from its original location. Now let me place it back here. Okay, so you can see the cursor has appeared. Now place the mouse pointer in this area, right click the mouse button again. From the drop down menu, click on this paste button. We call this as a paste button. Click here. You can see it has been shifted to another position, so we call this as moving a text. Okay, now what is copying a text? Again select these two sentences. After selecting, now under the home tab, just below the cut option, you can see a copy button here. Okay, so this time I am not going to click on cut, I am going to click on copy. Now once I click on the copy, what happened? These two sentences has been copied. Now where I want to place it? Say I want to place it somewhere here. The cursor has appeared. Okay, now again go to the paste button here, click on the paste button. You can see that two texts or two sentences has appeared here. Now you can see that my original copy is already here. Now what has happened is only the duplicate copy of the text has been shifted from its original position to a new position, okay, without removing the text. So we call this as a copy paste feature. Now suppose say if you want to make a copy of this one, one more copy. Now I have already copied this one, no need to copy again. Okay, simply click on the paste button here, so it will appear. So another way is, suppose say let me select the entire sentence. Okay, now right click the mouse button. This is another method. Okay, click on the copy button from the drop down menu. Now where you want to place it? Suppose say I want to place it somewhere here. Okay, you can see that the cursor has appeared. Now right click the mouse button and click on the paste button here. Now you can see the whole paragraph has been copied. You can see that the original paragraph is here. Okay, and this is the duplicate paragraph. So we call this as a copy paste feature. Okay, so in today's session we have learned how to type the text. Okay, you have also learned how to select the text, whether it is a word, whether it is a sentence, whether it is a paragraph, by using a mouse button and moving the text and copying the text. Okay, so this is all in today's class. So kindly do practice it at home. Thank you, children.